There is certainly a rising number of successful women doing business in Uganda, all trading at different levels as they defy stereotypes to make it and contribute to Uganda's economy. Much as most women are successful, many fail or give up for various reasons.
We are encouraging you to boast because no man would boast for you. Because that, except Juma here, my younger brother, he's the one who will say, the women are like this, the women are like that. Because every time people look at you, they look at you from negative. They don't give you a plus even before you start.
She appeals to financial institutions, especially the banks, to make finances more available to women to enable them start up businesses, among other innovations.
And I'm telling you, the bankers, the reason you lost to mobile money is because for the first time women got their space and they were able to communicate and they were able to put technology in their hands.
She further urged government to draw more emphasis to the empowerment of women by recruiting them to key positions.
Because when you put women in politics to make decisions on finance, to make decisions on education, to make decisions on health, to make decisions on law, to make decisions on accountability, everywhere in the world, everybody is saying on average, women always do better.
Meanwhile, several women were awarded for their outstanding business ideas.
It's good for them to save, but they should not wait to save a lot of money to start. Save, get some as long as Omutaina idea.
According to research done by Uganda Women Entrepreneurs Association Limited, women own 45% of businesses in Uganda and are champions of change, but the gap between success and failure widens with various challenges, among which is access and cost of credit as one of the biggest barriers, exposure of their businesses and access to markets, among others. Rachel Nachwala for Urban TV. I'm not afraid.